Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Caitlin Adams. I'm the choir director for Cadillac Junior High and High School. I've been working at the high school for 6 years. The group you see in front of me is the very last group of students who had me as a teacher in kindergarten. So they're the last group that remembers me as an elementary music teacher. So it is an absolute thrill to work with all of them again. Some of them didn't have me as a teacher, but I'm going to pretend because I like them. Tonight, we have a very quick concert. At the beginning of the year, our main focus area is tone quality production, being able to form our vowels properly and in exactly the same way every time. It is an ongoing process. You'll hear, if you happen to come to our variety show on Saturday, even the honors choir seniors who have been studying music, some of them now for 7 years in just choir, most of whom have taken voice lessons, forming vowels exactly the same every time is incredibly difficult. So that is our focus at the beginning of the year, thus this concert is rather short. Our first piece tonight is Ba Ba Swingin' Sheep. You will recognize Ba Ba's Black Sheep, the lovely little nursery rhyme piece, as well as some new music. Enjoy. Piece, I'm going to move the microphones. In the program, I did leave out some names, and I'm sorry for that. This piece, this song is for the children, has five folks singing the descant, a descant being a harmony above the melody in this case. Corbin Martin, Mikhail McGuire, Haley Wingard, Allison Roberts, and Nevaeh Berner. I'm going to put the mics, these over here, and we're going to do the song all together. Thank you. I have a small query. Next in the program, is it a trio or is it a presentation by Cadillac Area Public Schools?
Trio.
The trio. Oh, thank you. Trio, if you could join us. This was a lovely, lovely experiment. I wanted to see what our kids could do if I handed them music and said, have fun. And I'm so thrilled with the results. These ladies have been working very hard to make this lovely for all of you. So we are going to do Johnny is a Soldier, Shula Gra, an old Irish tune. Ladies, you can move these as close together as you see fit.
John is gone for the soldier. John is gone.
Amber. Amber and I share a favorite musical, and so I had to bring it up, and then she had to do some moves. Tonight, you are about to see a facility planning masterpiece. Cadillac Area Public Schools, we have been asked to share a video that sets the stage for future planning at Cadillac Area Public Schools. We are grateful for the generous contributions. Eighth grade. We are grateful for the generous contributions made by individuals that were willing to be videotaped for the project and the Boardman Video Production for their donation of time and talent. This information video is intended to invite everyone to join the conversation about planning for the next 50 years of educating CAPS kids. Your voice matters. Community forums will take place on November 1st and 9th at 6:30 p.m. in the Media Center across the hall. A light dinner will be provided.
I love to learn.
To be part of a team.
To create.
To play!
To be engaged!
To grow strong!
To be inspired!
Yay!
Cadillac Schools embodies a rich history. Nearly 50 years ago, the Board of Education and Community renamed the schools Cadillac Area Public Schools, setting forth a plan to provide students excellence in academics, the arts, and athletics.
We hope to recognize where we have come in the past 50 years and set forth a course that defines a future that includes educator, parent, student, and community input as we reestablish our shared values.
In 50 years, we acknowledge that many things have changed. We accept the need to consider future possibilities while respecting our responsibility to children's safety, advancing technology, and real-world learning experiences.
We hope to set the course together and encourage feedback and participation. We're asking for your help as CAPS considers some serious questions regarding education for today and for the future.
We want to engage the entire community, everyone, giving us input about what it's going to take to educate our children for the next 50 years.
Our community is healthy and growing.
We're welcoming.
We believe in strong, collaborative community relationships.
We know our legacy is important.
We believe in partnering for kids because all of our futures depend on it.
We know that this is a community that cares. Thank you for your help as we take this journey together.
We know that education is critical for growth, and our kids deserve the best.
For generations, Cadillac Public Schools has prepared students well for the future. It all began with one-room schoolhouses.
And spanned 150 years of progress and pride. From farmhouses to a lumbering town, to the establishment of a strong industrial community. In our school's history, the 1950s and 60s are notable in that our one-room schools closed and the current school buildings that we are familiar with were built.
In the 1990s, some dire needs were addressed and the community banded together to support the building of Mackinac Trail Middle School and renovating Lincoln Elementary. Additionally, repairs and improvements were made to Cadillac High School and other aging buildings in the district. In 2017, we will celebrate 50 years of educating students in the district known as Cadillac Area Public Schools. The buildings our students attend range from 20 years old to 100 years old. As education evolves, so does our responsibility to prepare future generations. As we look to the future, we need to consider educational spaces that are efficient, cost-effective, and meet the educational needs of future generations. Cadillac Area Public Schools, a proud heritage.
Bryson?
Our current education was designed for a different age.
The factory model principles that had great economic success during the Industrial Revolution were applied to the design of schools. The Industrial Revolution gave way to the information age, and a close examination of the role of schools occurred when the Russians put Sputnik into space. As a result, a national movement began to increase expectations, especially in math and science. We began to understand that children learned better by doing and not memorization of facts. And then the internet happened. No longer was just knowing the facts valuable when I can just Google it. Today, there is a great value in communication, collaboration, complex problem solving, creating, and innovating. As every country in the world works to reform education so that our children can take their place in a new global economy, we can't prepare them for the future by doing what we have done in the past. Our children are living in the most intensely stimulating period in all of history. Schools need to look different, be different. We need to design educational experiences that wake our children up to their potential and prepare them to be future ready.
Differentiated instruction is when I take into account all the things that make my students who they are. It's essential. It's not just important. It's something that we really have to do, especially in kindergarten. Little bodies were not meant to sit still. I need to give my students the opportunity to move, and I do that by giving them different places where they can do their work. I make sure that my classroom is a place where they can move freely. They have the opportunity to choose where they work. Their need to move is greater than their need to sit still and listen. But if I can give them an outlet, places that they can work, different things that they can use to do their jobs, then it helps them be more successful.
So personalized technology in the classroom means that I have the ability to differentiate for kids based on where they are in their learning. So I have the ability to give feedback that is immediate and is meaningful to individual students. I have the ability to reach kids in a way that is different than I could in the past. We're teaching students skills. We talk about it first on a small scale within our classroom. What are our norms? What do people need to do when they comment on someone's blog post? What should they say? What should they not say? Even in terms of responding to each other's writing.
So I built the stand-up tables that are behind me, and we're able to create some tables for kids that got restless sitting in chairs and needed that place to be able to stand up. And it works great. They love them.
School safety is critical to our operations. We take great pride in keeping students safe.
Our country's economy began in agriculture, but quickly evolved to manufacturing throughout the Industrial Revolution. Innovative technologies resulted in automation and globalization. The internet made e-commerce possible and began the longest period of economic expansion. Globalization of manufacturing increased competition to manufacture cheaply. In order to compete, companies were forced to move work to countries with less regulation and lower wages. In the last decade, virtual marketplaces and automation are eliminating the need for low-skill, service-oriented jobs. The workplace has been revolutionized with mobile technologies. There is a need for a future-ready workforce. A workforce that can create, innovate, collaborate, communicate, solve complex problems, think critically, and analyze. We need to anticipate labor gaps and prepare a future workforce. We are living in a world few could imagine 50 years ago. We are now preparing children for jobs that yet do not exist.
As an employer, Cadillac Area Public Schools is a key component to ensure our workforce can compete globally.
The energy industry is changing rapidly, and to compete, we have to hire talented and creative people that can collaborate to solve problems in a changing world.
Healthcare professionals are committed to their own education, and they want the same for their children. It's really important that we have high-performing schools in Cadillac so that we can recruit and retain healthcare professionals in our community.
We need people who are self-directed and motivated to work.
We need creative thinkers who communicate well with our clients.
We need hard workers with strong interpersonal skills.
Skilled workers with tenacity and a willingness to do whatever it takes to get the job done.
School has really not only taught me academic knowledge, but it's given me the confidence to pursue my goals and succeed in life.
School has taught me to work as a part of a team, which will help me after high school in whatever job I choose to pursue.
Cadillac High School has prepared me for my adult life, especially in the aspect of contributing to my society and being an active member in my community.
We know that CAP staff care about their students and are committed to their craft.
They use creativity to personalize learning for our students in a time of dramatic change in a global economy.
Today in education, places and spaces matter more as we deliver education in a new time.
We strive to keep the places and spaces that our students spend each day safe, relevant, dynamic, and engaging while staying committed to our budgets. For a moment, imagine the future in our schools. What does this look like for our students? How can we improve our spaces and places and remain fiscally responsible? What do the next 50 years look like here in our students' classrooms? Help us to take a closer look together so that we stay the course fiscally and educationally while we prepare our students for tomorrow's opportunities.
Help us figure this out and create a plan for CAP's future.
Help us identify how we can best prepare the future generation.
Help us to determine our destiny,
find happiness,
meet our potential,
and define success.
Small group presentations will take place this fall, and large community forums will take place this winter. Please join us, and let's continue a tradition of excellence. Visit www.vikingnet.org for more information and ongoing dates.
This is my last hour class of the day. It's fun to end with these guys. And this is our wonderful pianist, Mrs. Margie Annis. I've been privileged to work with Mrs. Annis for 6 years, and it has been an absolutely wonderful partnership. She supports the kids in everything they do, and we're very, very lucky to have her. Our next piece is Make It So, followed by Something Told the Wild Geese.
Are you mine?
directly after these three pieces, from the King Singer's Book of Rounds and Canons, which I like to use as our warm-ups because it's a very simple way to teach part singing along with tone quality. We're going to very quickly tear down what is on stage and set up for the band concert. It's going to be very tight in here for a little bit as you exit and band families leave or come in to the auditorium. And in some cases, you might be staying, in which case you are awesome. And congratulations, you get to see more great music. So we're going to begin with Music Alone Shall Live.
My dame hath a lame tame.